Hey, this is David with the Shepherd School, and today what we're going to do is make sun-dried tomatoes. You know when you go to the grocery store and you get the jars of tomatoes, the dried tomatoes packed into olive oil? That's what we're going to make today. Now, Roma tomatoes, paste-type tomatoes, work best for this, but you could use any kind of tomato that you want. We kind of had to go with what our garden had ready for us, and depending on your preference, you could take the skins off or leave the skins on. I'm going to leave the skins on simply because I don't want to go through the trouble of de-skinning them. And we did a video on that in the processing tomatoes video a couple years ago. You know, basically you just boil it and then throw it in some cold water and the skins will come right off. So basically all we're going to do is we're going to dehydrate these and then we come back, I'll show you how to do the rest. So simply we're just going to slice them. And put them on our dehydrator. Try not to let them touch, but we're not gonna get too crazy over it. If they do, they do. And we're going to put this at our vegetables setting at 135 degrees. We're going to come back in about 6 hours and check it out. Okay? Okay, so we checked our tomatoes at 6 hours and they were still kind of rubbery, right? So we let them cook a little bit longer. It's been about 12 hours and they are done. They're how I want them to be. Now, what you can do, and I've seen some studies where it talks about storing in oil really doesn't extend the shelf life as much as some people claim, and that alternatively it's better to store your dried tomatoes in vacuum seal bags, in dry vacuum sealed environment, and just put them in oil when you're ready to use them. I plan on using these relatively quickly because I like putting them on, bread and stuff. So we're going to go ahead and do ours in oil. I'm going to leave it up to you whether you think this is the best way to store or not. But what we're going to do is we're going to layer our tomatoes in a clean mason jar with some fresh basil leaves that I picked from the garden. It's awful hot, so as soon as I picked them, they started wilting. A little bit of minced garlic, some oregano, and my recipe says kosher salt. I've got pickling salt. It's just non-iodized salt is what you want to use, okay? And then once we get them layered, I'm going to fill the jar up with some olive oil, okay? And the better quality olive oil, the better your product's going to be, but I just use some bulk olive oil. It's not the best in the world, but it'll do for what we're doing. All right. Salt. Oregano, a couple leaves, some garlic. You don't want to fill your jar all the way up to the top because in the beginning some of your tomatoes might float. And to preserve this, you want everything to be submerged, okay? So now that we've used up all our tomatoes, and this was what? About 4 slicing tomatoes and about 4 Roma tomatoes. All right. And I used a wide mouth lid, wide mouth jar, so it would be easy to get this out when I'm done. And so we're just going to keep this for about a week, 6 to 8 9 days or so, because you want the oil to penetrate back in and rehydrate these tomatoes a little bit. Okay? And so that's all there is to it. And it kind of looks pretty. It doesn't look too terribly bad. So anyway, until next time, you can always catch us online at www.tngun.com. And to read the article about this, you can look at the annotation at the top of the video. I appreciate it. Thank you.